The plant that exists today isn't the same plant that it was in 1973 when we first started up.
The scope of this project has reached and touched every organization on this site. Everyone is touched and affected and supporting this project in one way or another.
I've worked a lot of major projects throughout the country, but nothing of this magnitude. It's definitely a historic project.
For me and most of the guys here involved in this project, it's a sight to see.
This is the largest construction project that we have ever undertaken on the turbine floor since initial construction in the late 60s and early 70s here at Browns Ferry. We're gonna get to make 7 more megawatts of electricity. Over 3,900 megawatts of carbon-free electricity are gonna flow from our power plant here.
The Unit 2 low-pressure turbine replacement project replaces all 3 low-pressure turbine rotors, replaces the inner cylinders. We're gonna have brand new diaphragms and blade carriers for the condenser, all new steam piping and extraction bellows, replacing 6 steam inlet lines, which is very rarely done in the nuclear industry.
We're replacing everything that goes with the turbine assembly.
The amount of scaffolding that we put in the condenser this outage is something I've never seen. The amount of crane lifts, the tonnage that's being moved up on the turbine floor, it's really unbelievable to see it all going on.
Well, any project of this magnitude has got a number of different challenges associated with it. A big piece is just the coordination of all the work.
Not long after we got started with our meetings and during the preparation, the pandemic broke out. Pulling a project off of this magnitude during the middle of a pandemic and being able to get everybody together and get your plan solidified.
It's been a challenge with the pandemic, you know, but I think we've adapted to it.
Our supply chain networks worldwide were affected by the COVID pandemic. We had team members scattered across 3 separate continents pulling together the procurement and the delivery of the major components.
They came via plane, they came via boat, they came via truck, and getting all that shipped and coordinated here to support on-time outage execution was really a challenge.
You know, with just a single crane for each unit kind of makes it difficult, but you know, we manage around it.
We have over 600 crane lifts that we're executing.
And every crane lift had to be scheduled and managed and coordinated to the minute.
Because this isn't the only thing we're doing in this refueling outage. We're doing a lot of other work in our condensers. Obviously, we're refueling the reactors. We're doing a significant amount of it. So how do you choreograph or coordinate all that work together so that you don't have people working on top of each other, and then it can all be done safely and can all be done efficiently? Those partnerships that we have with our contract companies, you know, that where they support, whether that be General Electric, Dan Zimmerman, Westinghouse, you know, all these different contract partners, and we can't do this without them.
Building a partnership with TVA, I think that's where, you know, TVA was able to reach out to all the, you know, in the industry and say, hey, this is our project and we need you involved.
We do feel like we're a key member of the Browns Ferry team. When issues arise at the plant, they reach out to us just like we're part of them.
And they come to work every day and they are part of our team. That's what makes you feel good, you know, as a TVA leader and as an employee of TVA, is that we're not on an island. We have people who want us to succeed and they are there with us, staying in line to get it done. This project signifies an investment in our facility, an investment in our community, and an investment in the 7 states that we serve.
It's important not only for the people of the Valley, but for TVA. You know, for reliable energy.
TVA's focus is that long-term investment strategy to make sure that our power plants and our infrastructure and our transmission systems and our people are the best available so that 60 and 80 years from now, when we're still operating these plants reliably, we have got that legacy of carbon-free, reliable power for the people we serve. And it's about creating that legacy, and you have to invest to create the legacy. At the end of the day, what really makes us special is the people who work here. Whether that be machinists, pipe fitters, electricians, iron workers, INC technicians, operators, RP technicians. We have some of the most skilled people at this facility who work here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, and they are committed to the success of the station.
They feel a lot of pride. Feel a lot of pride that they're here, you know, being part of it, you know, and it shows with the accomplishments that we've gotten so far.
They're proud that we're the 2nd largest power plant in the country. right? And we're going after number one, right? We're going to get there. We're going to get there. And they're proud of that. They're proud that we're the powerhouse of the South.